I'm Ari Rabinowitz from Vim News. I hear that the animal department is closing down. Is there any reason why only the animal department is closing down, now the Toyota Living Museum?
The animal section building is being sold. The animals are not being closed down. Some of the animals are going to be moved over to the other buildings that we have, and some are going to be taken to the Catskill location to be put in the Catskill location. Due to the financial circumstances since 2008, the number of sponsors have gone down considerably, and we have incurred a lot of debt. We have to sell off one of the buildings, but the other two buildings will remain, and the museum will be consolidated, and the animals will be consolidated into the other two buildings.
What was the hardest item to import for you?
Hardest item as far as the animals are concerned, the elephant was the hardest.
Why are you considering that the hardest?
Because it's very big and it's very hard to transport and to get. So the elephant was definitely the hardest for us to get and to bring it.
Mm-hmm. What's the history behind getting some approvals from President Bush and President Barack Obama?
Basically, you don't need, most of the animals do not need approvals. Most of the animals, if they're not considered endangered or anything, are okay. There are certain animals that need permits. They're called CITES permits, that need permits, and our taxidermists, the people who do a lot of these things, organize these things. And if you see in some of the animals the tags that they have on their feet and everything, those are specific animals that need special government approval.
And which item was the most hardest to get at all? Not to import, just to get.
There's a combination of many different items that were hard for us to get because of, you know, the approvals that are necessary. I would say some of the birds were difficult, and some of the kangaroo was a very difficult thing. We wanted to show kids what a kangaroo looks like with a baby. That one needed a special approval, and that we got as well.
How many people visited the animal department since you were open?
It comes to about 35,000 a year that was visiting. We have a lot of schools that come here. Families, groups, visitors, tourists. So it's a combination of many, many different people that come.
When are the day you plan to close down the animal department?
We're not closing the animal department. As I said, we're going to consolidate some of those into the current buildings that we have. We're going to move it. That's dependent on the sale of the building.
So you're saying once this building is sold, then no visitations will be allowed there anymore for the animals?
There will be no reservations in that building, but there will be still tours of animals in our other buildings as well.
And all other stuff will be moved over?
In that building is only animals. So all the animals will be moved over, either some to the current buildings that we have here, or some will move to our Catskill Museum in the Catskills.
Did you any time had any official agency try to stop you bringing in something?
No.
They were sometime very helpful for you, or just regular? They gave you the permits, what
people
you asked for?
People were very helpful to us. People understand that we're an educational institute that's trying to use these animals in order to teach. We don't kill any animals. We don't destroy any animals. Our goal is that people learn something, should be able to see and understand. And that's the goal of the museum, education.
You had any big prominent rabbis or people who visited this museum here in Borough Park?
Rabbi Cheskel Roth, the Carlsberger Rav, Rabbi Yomel Lando. We have many, many rabbanim, Rabbi Yisrael Belsky, Rabbi David Cohen. We have a lot of different rabbanim who have come from all over to see it. We had over here the Taldasar and Rosh Hashiva. We had over here from Eretz Yisrael, many Gedolei Yisrael who have come to America have come to see the museum.
Any big Gedolei from Eretz Yisrael gave you some support for that?
Support. Reb Chaim Kanievsky was very much involved in helping us and giving us brachas for it. Reb Liashiv was very, very inspired by the things that we do with the museum. He was very interested in this as well.
Okay, thank you.